All aboard, please take your seats and have your tickets ready. While riding our train, please keep your electronic thingamajigs on silent. You never know what you may see in these here parts, so beware that a strobe light and loud noises may be coming your way. Thanks for traveling with us, and enjoy your ride.
Director of the darn company, how could I help the wretched engine stalling for no reason at all?
We could have gone by car, like I wanted to in the first place.
Oh, because you're always right. And that idiot with the feather in his hat seemed quite amused when I told him we'd missed our connection.
And you swore at him.
Well, why shouldn't I? Oh, here. Let's find out what there is in here.
Well, this here is the only place.
Oh, good Lord, what a hole.
Oh, Charlie.
Hey, you, what are you doing? You can't go in there.
Well, this looks a nice, cheerful little dump, I must say.
Never mind, dear.
But I do mind. And in case we forget, this is our wedding night.
Oh, yes.
Ooh, we don't want to hang around here long. And what will they say at the hotel if we don't turn up?
I hope they won't think you changed your mind at the last minute.
Oh, what a joke. Tonight of all nights to be stuck in a place like this. No, this is no joke. Look at it. I'm tired. You're hungry. We both want to get to our hotel. It was tough missing the train.
That was Mother's fault. I knew we would be late.
I'm furious. When we've only got this 1 week before I have to leave you and go abroad, I begrudge every moment wasted.
Let's forget about that, dear. Let's pretend we shall be together always.
Oh, I'm sorry, old girl. I won't gloom tonight of all nights. There's one thing about it, though. Those other folks seem to have cleared off, and we're alone together. Kiss me, and I'll smile again. Darling! Say that where there's smoke, there's fire, but not in this case.
I'm sure it's a very lovely fire for this time of night.
Well, we shall have to put up with it until the next train.
I keep on telling her there ain't no next train.
What?
What? There ain't no more trains till 7 tomorrow morning.
Well, I say, I've got to see this young lady, my wife, to Rockland tonight.
Well, you ain't gonna do it.
Well, then we must order a special.
Oh, yeah. A special! From here?
Yes.
There ain't no such thing on this line.
Oh, well, then where can we hire a car?
No ways that I know of.
Well, then what can we do?
I don't know what you'll do. I know what I'm going to do. I'm going home.
Oh, hell.
I'm sorry. Pegs, it seems as if we're in something of a mess.
It can't be helped, and I don't mind.
But good Lord, this is terrible.
Now, look here. Let me talk to this fellow. Now, see here, porter.
Ah! Excuse me, sir. Station master.
Well then, station master, do you really mean to say we can't get any further tonight?
Not on this line, you can't.
Well, where's the nearest hotel?
Rockland.
Oh, good Lord. But there must be some place or other we can go for the night.
There's a farm down the road.
Don't you live anywhere?
Yeah.
Where?
Rockland.
How do you get there?
Motorcycle.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it looks as though we shall have to put up with this till morning.
Oh. I say, where's that fellow with the feather in his hat who was so amused when the engine stalled?
That idiot.
Oh, there's another gentleman out there on the platform.
I wonder if he still thinks this is so funny.
If he finds anything to laugh at in this place, I'll murder him. Him with his damn hat.
Why wasn't he summoned or something? And why couldn't he leave his hands off the emergency cord?
Mm-hmm. Oh, porter! Porter! I say, station master.
Ah, yes, sir.
I say, where can I get a taxi around here?
Taxi? There ain't no such thing anywhere around these parts.
Oh, that's too bad. Did you know a silly ass out there called me a silly ass? Out there.
What? There ain't nobody out there, sir.
I know. That's what annoyed me. I said, do you know all this reminds me very much of a night I spent in a golf clubhouse outside Harrogate?
No.
It was Matlock. Anyway, it was one of those places where they have sulfur water. I remember because we were all so frightfully depressed at the time and it was raining. You know rain, don't you?
I do.
Well, there was this man there. And he...
Oh, puff.
I say, you don't seem to be very much interested, do you?
Well, frankly, I must confess, we're not.
That's too bad. I say, what a topping little crib.
Oh.
Oh, here we are, Arvin. And what were you priceless old things discussing?
Nothing important, and we were unanimous on the subject.
Ah, good egg. So, we're here till morning then, what?
Oh, yes.
I think it's all rather priceless, don't you think? Oh. A little adventure? Something to relieve the ballet monotony, what?
This may be an adventure for you, but we're in the devil of a mess.
Well, that's too bad. Now I'm quite enjoying myself.
Young man, have you no sense of responsibility?
Yes! Responsibility? Whatever is that, eh?
Oh, your ignorance of the word hardly surprises me.
Oh, come now. You're not pleased with me, are you?
You're like a conservative. Monstrous, sir, considering that you are the cause of this unpleasant situation.
Here, right. Here.
Oh, but my good woman.
I am not a good woman. I mean, I will not be addressed with unwarranted familiarity.
Oh, I understand.
But I say, you have to be fair, you know. How can I have my hat blowing away?
Well, if you stick your head out of a window, that's apt to happen.
But I say, old thing, I was only watching the sparks fly from the engine. I do so love sparks. I once wrote a little poem about them. If sparks were locks and sang at night, 'twould make the evening so bright if sparks were locks.
Losing your beastly hat was no excuse for pulling the emergency cord.
Don't you think so?
No.
Well, I do. It's a jolly nice hat. I'd only bought it last week. Besides, I've always wanted to pull the communication cord in such a refreshing idea, don't you think so?
Damn it, man! Have you no sense of decency?
Decency? What do you mean?
You don't seem to realize the facts of the case.
I hate facts.
Well, then giving you some will give me great pleasure. First of all, you stick your fool head out of the window like the silly ass that you are.
Yes.
Yes, and then when your beastly hat blows off, you pull the emergency cord and stop the train on an incline.
Yes, yes.
Yes, yes, and consequently, we miss our train connection and have to spend the night in this godforsaken hole.
Yes, that's quite right.
And instead of being sorry, why...
Damn it all, sir.
You strut around as if you had done us all a favor.
Oh, I say, you don't seem to like me very much, do you?
Well, if I could give you my candid opinion.
Oh, hello, don't haggle, Richard. Surely things are bad enough without a quarrel. I mean, here we are, and here we've got to stop.
Righty-ho, and I'm going to pick out a nice soft spot.
Beg pardon, ladies, but you can't stop here.
What?
I said as how you can't stop here.
What the blazes do you mean?
Well, there ain't no traffic on this line at night, so he shuts everything up. Signal boxes, station, the whole shebang. I'm off home.
Well, good night.
Oh, yeah, but before I go, I got to lock everything up.
Well, this time you can't lock everything up.
Beg your pardon, sir, but them's my orders and I got to obey them.
Don't be so damned idiotic. How about us?
You ain't no concern of mine. Orders is orders. You might go to that farm. How far is that?
Oh, about 5 miles.
Do you expect these ladies to walk 5 miles on a night like this?
I don't expect nothing, mister. All I expect to do is to walk up.
Is that so?
You can't stop me.
Who's to prevent us?
Me.
Oh, and are you going to throw us out?
Yeah. Oh, but mind you, I shall be very sorry to do it. Oh.
Don't worry about that. Just make a start of me! This morning, but you must realize how worried I am just now. My works manager dying suddenly like that? Oh, yes. And Perkinson was more than that. Oh, he was an expert, clear, level-headed. A man like that isn't easy to replace.
And because of that, I have to suffer?
Well, you must admit that you were exasperated.
Domineered. attraction to me. I can look after myself. I've never been afraid of anything in my life.
That's just it, Elsie. You're so damn self-reliant.
Oh, there you go. You're off again. I have had enough scenes for one day. I am going in the other room.
Elsie, for the last time. Let's start again.
No, Dick. I've made up my mind.
Oh, I beg your pardon.
Don't mention it. It's quite all right.
It's cheerful, isn't it?
Perfectly rotten.
Nothing we can do about it?
No, it looks as though we shall have to put up with this till morning.
It's pretty bad for you, of course, but I'm in a hell of a mess.
Oh, we all are.
I expect you've been married some time?
Yes.
Makes it a whole lot easier.
Does it?
Well, you see, we, my wife and I, we haven't been married very long. In fact, we... I'm afraid that rather gives it away. Well, hang it all, there's nothing to be ashamed of. We were only married this morning. But for God's sake, don't tell the others.
Oh, of course not.
It's wonderful to be married, to have somebody to stand by you through thick and thin.
You found that out?
You bet I have. And I'm glad I found out soon because we haven't much time.
Well, like you said, you just got married.
Yes, but...
Well, have you had a row?
Good Lord, no!
Well, of course not. I beg your pardon.
It's all right. Have rows sometimes?
Yes. Sometimes.
I can't understand it. As a matter of fact, my trouble is, my name's Murdoch.
Murdoch? Any relation to Murdoch and Son?
Yes, I'm the Son. Worse luck.
I see.
Well, our smash is pretty well known.
Well, I happen to notice it because I happen to be in the same line of business.
You are?
Huh?
That's strange.
You know the... Oh, yeah. Oh! Weren't you in charge of the Canadian branch of your firm?
Yes, you see, I was educated in England, so I mixed in rather well with the Toronto and Montreal branches. I just about had the business where I could have handled it from Boston when the big smash came.
Oh, I see. What rotten luck.
Oh, well, you've one competitor less anyway. No, I'm going to clear out. Try my luck in South America.
Alone?
Yes. Oh, it's impossible to bring the wife. Just this little honeymoon and then... It's hell.
So you don't want to separate?
Want to separate? What a question.
Huh, of course you don't. I didn't mean that.
Charlie! Where are you?
Here I am! Did you manage to get a wash?
Oh, yes. Oh, Methuselah managed to dig up a
wheat. Oh, is that right? And did it go very well for you?
Aha! Aha!
Mr.
Oh, Winthrop is my name.
Ah, Peggy, meet Mr. Winthrop. Mr. Winthrop, allow me to introduce you to my wife, Peggy.
Well, how do you do?
My wife.
Well, I bet you do too well, don't you?
My wife.
That's what they tell me down at the club.
Oh. My wife!
Nice to meet you.
We've just discovered that we're both in the same line of business.
Quite a coincidence. It's very strange.
Oh, no, please, don't let me drive you away.
Oh, no, not at all. There's something I have to say to my wife. Okay, I'm gonna, oh, there's the door. Okay, bye now.
Is that,
see you soon.
Oh, is that too long?
Why'd you get
short?
Is it deep?
Yes.
Say, thanks, old girl, this is not so good, is it?
No.
Well, it's not my idea of a honeymoon. Of course, if we were to be together always, it wouldn't be so bad.
Please, don't let's talk about it.
I'm sorry, Pegs. It's all so unfair. If only you could come.
I'm dying to come. You know that.
No, it's impossible. I may have to rough it a bit.
Oh, I wouldn't mind.
But I would. No, Pegs, I'm fitting well. It'll be different for you.
Well, I'm fitting well too, Charlie.
Well, I couldn't even raise the fare.
Well, we might borrow it.
Think so?
Lots of people seem willing to lend money.
Do they?
Yes, you can read about them in the papers.
Oh, no thanks, dear. You stay with your mother till things take a turn.
Yes, dear. I suppose you know best. But, darling, no matter what happens, I love you.
Oh, darling.
Old change, old change, line up on the right, please. Sorry, we're sold out of tickets to New York City. Nothing but weak hawking left.
No, I beg your pardon. It's all right. We're beginning to get a bit used to you.
Well, I think somebody likes me. Somebody loves me.
No, shut up.
Don't you like my voice?
No, we think it's terrible.
W-E-A-F, signing off. Good night, everybody.
That fellow's a lunatic.
This is the worst managed station I have ever been at in the entire course of my life. I shall certainly write a complaint about it to the company.
Oh, I wish you would, ma'am. Don, the conditions here ain't terrible.
What's the trouble?
Oh, it's raining into the roof in there. We had to clear out.
Oh, I'm getting hungry.
So am I. You got anything to eat here?
Nope, not a bite.
I'm sure I don't know what's the matter with my poor old Joey.
I'm not sure where it goes.
I'd rather be going home.
20 years
ago tonight, there was a man by the name of Ted Holmes, used to be in charge of this here station. Did you notice a bridge just down below?
Yes.
That's the bridge over Winslow's Creek. It's a swing bridge, and it used to be worked by a lever right out here on this very platform. In those days, what big-sized boats used to come up the creek for the China clay. But they don't come up here no more.
Why not?
20 years ago tonight, there was a party of people started off on some sort of a jolly vacation up to Rockland, and they chartered a special train to take them back home to Waldoboro, just down the line. And that was the last night train that ever run on these here tracks. Ted Holmes was kept on duty that night to close the bridge, which was always left open to let the clay boats go out on the tide. It must have been 11 o'clock when they phoned from Rockland for Ted to close the bridge that the special was a-starting. Ted phones back as how he closed the bridge that minute, and then was the last words he was ever heard to speak.
What happened?
That was at 11 o'clock, and Ted Holmes goes to that door there, and there it was. Some sickness overcomes him, and he falls down on that very platform, just outside that very door. Gape!
Oh, how shocking.
Outside that very door, they found him with the lamp still a-burning in his hand. It must have been 11:30 when the special left Rockland, and there was the bridge wide open, and Ted lying dead on the platform. On comes the train down the valley. On she comes, coming like hell, everyone being anxious to get home. On she comes, 40 miles an hour. Poor old Ben Isaacs was driving that night, and it seems as though something warned him. What it was, God only knows, but he collapsed on them brakes, and the train goes a-screaming and a-tearing through the station with all the brakes on and the whistles a-blowing, and then crash!
Oh, good God!
That's awful!
Were there many killed?
6 killed outright, 2 died after. By some miracle, Ben Isaacs was thrown clear. Then he makes his way out of the water and back here to this station. His mind gone. And they say he can be seen for hours a-walking that platform, a-waving his lantern, and singing Rock of Ages. The next morning, he died. And it were a merciful release. 6 bodies they brought up, and they laid him out in this very room.
Oh, what a horrible story.
Well, I warned you, it weren't no pretty tale, ma'am, but you would have it.
But where does the haunting come in?
Oh, well, maybe I've said enough. I don't want to scare the ladies.
No! It's a terrible thing, no doubt, but I don't see how it could frighten us. Please go on.
Ever since that night, this station has been haunted.
Who by? Ted Holmes?
Worse than that. Some nights, a signal bell rings, and a train comes a-screaming and a-tearing through the station with all the brakes on and the whistles a-blowing.
Oh, rot!
Oh, I'm telling you, it's a God's truth. I was kept late by a thunderstorm one night, not long back, and just as I get down the road, I heard a signal bell ring, and I saw her go through the station, saw the flames from the engine, saw it with my own eyes.
Oh, I expect there was some freight train that started this yarn.
I'm telling you, there ain't no trains that run on these here tracks from 10 o'clock at night till 7 in the morning. Besides which, it never starts in Rockland. It never runs into Waldoboro. If it be a natural thing, where does it come from? Where does it go?
Oh, rubbish.
You don't believe me.
I'm afraid you're superstitious.
All the folks round these parts run like the devil when they hear a train at night. Do you know what they say it means to look on the goose train?
No, what?
Death.
Oh, now you are talking rot.
All right, mister. One night late, not long back, there was a tramp that broke into this here waiting room. And the next day, they found him in here. Dead. And the doctors say as how he died of fear.
A coincidence.
No, but that don't explain the train. Besides, you hear it tearing down the line. There was a man from a farm back here trying to walk to Rockland early one morning to catch the boat to Bar Harbor when he sees someone a-walking the platform and a-waving a lantern and singing Rock of Ages. No, sir, you can stay here if you want to, but not me. They say the dead walk this platform at night with poor old Ben Isaac to lead them.
I think this is all perfectly priceless. I've never heard anything so delightfully funny in all my life.
What?
Why, you don't expect us to believe all that muck, do you?
You better believe it. It's bad luck to scoff at the dead.
Do you know? All this reminds me very much of a story I once heard about a haunted police station.
Oh.
Or a fire station.
Yeah.
Or something.
Okay.
In London.
Yes.
Or was it Manchester?
Okay.
No, it was Glasgow.
Well,
there was a man there one day, and he saw an old girl dressed all in brown sitting on a seat. And he said something to her, and she disappeared. And he thought how lucky. And then he walked around the corner again, and there she was again, all dressed in brown. And he said to her, it was a perfect scream, but he said,
what the devil did he say?
He said the funniest thing, but he said, well, now I've quite forgotten just what he did say, but I know that it was a perfect scream.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Oh, don't get peeved about it, old thing. You have to admit, man to man, your story was rather steep.
Oh,
but never mind. That reminds me of another story. About a clergyman.
Oh,
and he'd just been married. And he'd married a most unpleasant woman. There they were, walking along from the church to the honeymoon, the most unpleasant lady's handbag in his hand. And he said to her, no, I don't think so.
Oh, I shall never travel on this line again. They only seem to specialize in idiots. Isn't there a proper system for signaling?
It's only a single track, ma'am. Back when the accident happened, the line was just open. Things are different now, and the swing bridge never open.
What did you say the jolly old lever on the platform was for then?
Oh, that works. The switch to the siding runs up the old lumber mill, matter of 100 yards.
Well, station master, your story's been very entertaining, but a bit gruesome.
Oh.
I'm sorry, I can't believe it all.
Look!
What?
I saw someone looking in through that window!
No! To make the best of us jumpy, though most of us don't have the moral courage to own up to it.
Thank you.
I wasn't referring to you. Oh, station master, you got any more coal? Fire's almost out.
No, we haven't got a bit left, sir. Expect some in from Rockland tomorrow.
Oh, but it really is most awfully cold and damp. Why, it'll about finish my poor bird. Oh, the egg will be frozen and all that trouble for
oh, do cheer up, people. It's sure to get worse.
That's all very well for you to talk to, man. You have landed us in this most unpleasant situation, and instead of expressing regret, no, 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 no! All you can do is sit and make fun of us! You're an impudent, ill-mannered puppy, sir! My poor sister will be sitting up all night for me, and here I am stuck in a cold railway station with ghosts and things all over the place, and all you can do is laugh! I hate the sight of you. I'll not stop another moment in the same room with you. Try to lead a better life, and don't come near me.
Good God!
My dear sister, all those years there never seemed any possibility of anything terrible ever happening to us.
But nothing has happened to you.
Nothing happened? My dear child, how can you say such a thing? I shall never be the same woman again.
Oh, you really must try and pull yourself together.
I'll try. I'll try. I think I do feel a little bit better.
Don't stop.
Oh, yes, as a matter of fact, I'm not as nervous as I was.
It's all right, it's only us.
Oh, John.
Now, ladies, this is a very unpleasant business, and it's given us all a bit of a jar, but we should try and not take it too seriously.
Can't we get away somewhere?
Oh, I wish we could, but it's raining harder than ever. It's coming down in sheets. Besides, there's nothing to be afraid of now. We put that poor fellow in the other room and locked the door. Let's just try and forget about it.
Forget?
Ah, we must be sensible. You know, there's hardly a home in America where someone hasn't died. Hardly a station where someone hasn't met with an unfortunate accident. And as for that poor fellow in there, well, people do die suddenly sometimes, and we have the consolation of knowing that he was spared any pain or suffering.
So you don't think his death had anything to do with the story he told us?
Oh, my dear girl, dismiss that from your mind. It was just a coincidence.
And a jolly strange thing, wasn't it? It was just what he said had happened. Every detail.
Oh, shut up!
Well, that's all very well, old thing, but I think I'm entitled to my opinion as well as anyone else.
You're not entitled to frighten people.
Why, I had no such idea in my head. I was only just thinking now of a story I once heard about some people who spent the night in a haunted mill.
Oh.
Or shop.
Please, no.
Or something.
Sure.
And just as the clock was striking midnight.
We don't want that story.
Oh, don't get peeved about it, old thing. I don't believe in ghosts myself. As a matter of fact, I think this whole thing is all rather a scream. You know? But then again, on the other hand, so did the people who spent the night in that haunted mill.
Okay.
Or shop.
Sure.
Do you know they hadn't been there more than a half an hour when they heard the most horrible...
Will you shut up?
Very well, I will. And just for that, I shan't tell you the story at all.
I'm sure there's some terrible supernatural force at work.
Oh, nonsense.
Well, that's what you said before, and yet look what happened.
Now, I said it was pure coincidence.
It's no good worrying about it, Miss Bourne.
Well, what about their face at the window?
That might have been only my imagination.
And it might not. I'm perfectly sure I saw something move in that other room.
Listen!
What is it?
Step outside.
You're not usually so nervous, Pegs.
I'm absolutely certain, Charlie.
Oh, I'll soon settle this.
No!
Thank you.
So, you feel better now?
I wasn't aware that I was ill.
You know what I mean, just now.
Well?
Well, when we found that fellow dead, I was anxious about you. You were quite hysterical.
I lost my head for a moment. That was all. I wasn't really afraid.
Well, of course not. I was here, wasn't I?
Yes. It would have been just fine had you not been here.
Are you sure?
I told you I don't need protection.
So then that separation idea still goes?
Of course, why not?
No, no, I thought perhaps you might have changed your mind.
No, no, I know,
I know. See you now.
That's funny. Her getting lit up as easy as all that.
Now she emptied the flask.
Oh, perhaps it's as well for the poor soul. No. She might not wake up until it's daylight.
Damn hard lines on me. Well, I didn't expect on her swinging the entire issue. I might as well get 40 winks too if you think you can manage without my advice.
Oh, well, we'll manage somehow. Thanks, rightfully. It's not a bad idea.
Wait a bit. I've just thought of something.
Well?
That telephone must connect to another station.
It's no good. I tried it a while ago. It seems to be out of order.
Oh, well, that settles that.
Delusions at times. So you mean she is...
Oh, hardly that. It's all this infernal ghost train business. She was near the station one night several years ago, and she thought she saw the train.
I did see it. You know I saw it. I did see it.
Now, dear.
You see, she comes from Cornwall, England, and she believes in ghosts. She always has, ever since she was a child. I sometimes feel there's something psychic about her. Well, anyway, she thought she saw the ghost train, and it was a great shock. So great a shock that it upset her permanently. Oh, she's perfectly well most of the time, but there are nights when she gets the idea that the ghost train will run, and it is a morbid fascination for her. She feels that she must see it again. This is one of her bad nights.
Yeah.
Now, I hope you'll understand.
It will come tonight. I know it will. It will come tonight.
Oh, nonsense.
It's not nonsense. I know it. I can feel it. I'm never wrong. That night the tramp died. I felt it then.
There you are, you see. Don't let it alarm you. Now, how did you get to know the story?
Oh, the old station master. He told us that yarn about an hour ago.
Oh, old Saul Hutchkin.
Where is he?
Well,
by
the way. You see, something very strange has happened here tonight. See, old Saul didn't want us to stay here tonight. He didn't think it was safe.
There. You see, he felt it too.
Yeah, so he told us the whole story and said he should go home.
Yes, he wouldn't stay here.
No.
Oh, I don't blame him. I wouldn't stay here if I could help it.
Good, then come along.
But I can't help it. You know I can't. It's that train. I've got to see it again. I don't want to see it, but I've got to see it. It makes me see it.
Never mind about that. You were saying?
Well, you were saying he said that he should go home, so he grabbed his bicycle lamp. And he lit it, and he went away.
And then,
a short while later, we heard a noise outside the door. And when we opened it, well, that's where we found him.
Dead.
Oh, my God.
Now, you see? Now, perhaps you believe me. You know it was something supernatural.
Yes, that's the way they found him.
Steady. Whoa, hey, buddy, we don't know you. Hands off of
me. I'm a doctor, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, wow, he's so handsome.
Where is this poor fellow? Let me see him.
Well, we carried him into the ticket office.
I'll go and examine him.
You'll see what business this is. He gave us a shock.
Naturally. Come along, Julia. It's time to be off.
No, I must stay here. It's that train. Oh, everything is bearing me out. That train won't let me go.
Now, there's a lot of difference between the coincidence of two men falling dead and some phantom train.
But the death of Ted Holmes was just the beginning of it 20 years ago tonight.
Say, what's the joke?
Huh?
It's on us, all right. Although, under the circumstances, it's not in the best of taste. Where do we laugh?
I don't get you.
Didn't you tell us that Saul Hodgkin dropped dead?
Yes, and we carried him in there. Why?
Go and look.
He isn't in there.
No!
It must be! Oh, good God!
This joke is beyond me, gentlemen, especially considering my niece's state of health.
But we all saw him! I've got it.
What's that?
Don't you see?
See what?
It was Ted Holmes!
Oh, no!
What are you crying
at? It's all terribly clear. Listen to me. Don't you know that Ted Holmes was a man very similar to Saul Hodgkin?
What?
Yes, my father knew him well. I'll bet you anything you like that Saul Hodgkin is safe at home in his bed this very minute. It was him you found outside the door. It was Ted Holmes. It was Saul Hodgkin. Then where is he? A man can't vanish into the air.
This is absurd.
At the time when all of this happened, it was 11 o'clock.
Well, yes.
Oh. I knew it! Oh. It was Ted Holmes!
No.
We've got to get out of here somehow.
Come along, Julia.
What?
be away again, just as you did before. You know as well as I do that that train will come, and you will not believe me. You pretend it's my delusion. You just want to get me put away again. That's what you want. Well, I shan't. No, no, no. I won't stir from here. I will prove to you that I'm not wrong about this.
But I know.
No, don't kill me.
There's enough of this. That's enough of this.
Steady, dear. Now listen to him, Price. Why can't you humor her a little? She'll be as right as rain in the morning. Now, why don't you go home and leave her to me? I can manage her better. You seem to excite her. I'll get her away from here, I think, and if not, let her stay. The train won't come, and that may put an end to these attacks of hers. Well, what do you say? Is it worthwhile?
All right, I'm going. I'm hanged if I'm going to stay around here all night.
Now, are you going? Good night.
Where is he going?
He's going home. Now, you have a little rest, and then we'll all go.
No, I'm going to stay here.
Oh, very well, dear. Just as you like.
It isn't what I like. It's because I've got to. It's that train. This place terrifies me. This room is full of eyes that all stare at me. Stare. Why do you look at me like that? You all think I'm bad, but I'm not mad. It's this room. It's full of evil.
Then why not go away from it?
Why do you keep saying that to me? Why are you so cruel? You know I would if I could. Why don't you help me?
Well, we want to help you.
You're just the same as all the rest. You're just as afraid of the place as I am. But you won't own it. You blame me.
Everything's all right. I'll stay with you.
And if the thing happens, you won't say I'm mad anymore?
Of course not. Everything considered? It might be better for you people to follow Price's example and clear out.
Yeah, I admit, it's awkward.
It's only about 5 miles to the farm and only about 5.5 to Price's house. It might be better to risk the wedding than to bring on any further unpleasant experience.
What do you think, Pegs?
Just as you like. I'm not afraid, but I'm with you.
Persuaded her into taking a little bit of brandy, and then something grabbed our attention for a moment, and she
holed out in one. Beats me how she did it.
Oh, so she's...
She wasn't used to it.
No, I don't know about that. A capacity like that can't be acquired all in a moment, you know. What?
You're an idiot.
What a head she'll have in the morning.
You see, it puts us in rather a quandary.
Leave the lady with us.
Oh, well, what if she should wake? It might give her quite a shock.
It's the only way out.
Listen, everyone, I've got a simply tumbling notion. It's raining outside, and I'm not going to walk 5 miles in the rotten rain for any ghosts. I'll stay here and look after Miss Ford. I think she rather likes me, or at least she ought to after she took all my brandy.
No, you're going with the others.
I think we should stay. What do you think, Elsie?
I'm not afraid.
What do you think, Pegs? Shall we stick it out?
I'm game.
All right, that's settled, then. We stay.
Hey! If you want my opinion, you're being very ill-advised.
Oh, not at all. I think this whole affair is all jolly sporting.
Very well. If you've made made up your mind.
Do you know, this all reminds me very much of the story I heard about those people who spent the night in the haunted mill.
Oh, come on.
Oh, shut up. Do you know they hadn't been there more than a half an hour when they heard the most horrible...
Yes, what did they hear?
Well, they heard... The most horrible...
We don't want that story.
But it's quite a drawing room story.
It would be better to take the ladies away.
They say when it comes, you can hear the bell ringing dismally, frightfully. I wonder if the bell will ring tonight. Just listen.
Steady, dear. Steady.
It will be here soon. I can feel it. Look!
It's all right. It's only the wind.
Oh, this is just strange.
Come here. Let's go into the other room. This place isn't good for you. Come.
You will open the door. You will find him there. Again. Dick! Shall we go too?
We may as well.
I'd have given anything in the world to have spared you a night like this.
It's not your fault, dear. And perhaps it has its bright side, too. It'll teach us to face things together, always.
But I can't bear to see you frightened. What can we do?
Well, perhaps that poor girl was right. I must learn to control myself. It's silly of me to be frightened when I have you to look after me. Charlie, why don't you answer me? Charlie! Where are you? Charlie, where are you?
Oh, Ben, it's okay. Here I am. It's all right, dear. I thought I heard whispering outside, so I went to go see who it was.
I said, I want to talk to you two.
You do?
Yes. I want to warn you about something.
What is it?
Well, the funny part about it is that I don't know, but I feel that it's my duty to warn you.
Well, what about?
Well, I've got a sort of presentiment, you know, a kind of nasty feeling. I feel that we haven't gotten over the worst of this yet.
Oh, well, there's nothing like being optimistic.
I know, I'm trying to be. I'm trying, but I feel pretty sure that the worst is yet to come.
Oh, don't talk rot, man.
But I don't think it is rot. I want you to promise me something, will you?
No, it's all according to what it is.
I want you to promise me that if anything unpleasant happens, that you'll be guided by me.
Ah! By you!
Yes. Hey, you needn't look so beastly surprised. I'm not the silly ass that I look.
Well, I didn't think you could be.
As a matter of fact, I think I'm rather a cute bird. Okay. And I want you to promise to back me up.
What are you going to do?
Well, that's the funny part about it. I haven't the faintest idea.
This is no time for kidding.
Why, my dear old thing, I've never been more serious in all my life. Give me your hand.
What?
I want you to hold this. Hey, don't show it to everyone. Put it in your pocket. Now, do you understand me?
No, I don't.
You don't, neither do I, but I can depend on you to back me up, can't I?
You're a great person to put yourself at the head of a party, aren't you?
Do you think so, old bean?
No, I'm damned if I do.
But you'll do as I tell you.
I shall use my own discretion.
Oh, I shouldn't do that.
I say, you people.
Oh, yes?
I've been thinking this matter over, and I've come to this conclusion. We don't know what we're up against in here, so we ought to all stand together.
Of course.
I want to know if you'd be willing to back me up.
What at?
Well, I don't know exactly.
It's most extraordinary that you should say that. I've just been asking them to back me up. Ha-ha!
You? Who?
Yes, why not? Ho-ho!
Hell! I shouldn't have thought you'd be much use in a crisis.
Who? Oh, can I say?
Hush! What was that?
Well, I didn't hear anything.
It was just that poor girl in the other room.
It's all right, Julia. It's over now.
Over? Why, it hasn't even started. The
Then go away.
Why do you keep saying that to me? Why don't you all go away and leave me?
Because we're not afraid.
That makes it all the more dangerous. Why don't you take my advice? You all think I'm mad, but I'm not mad when that train comes.
The train won't come.
We ought to be prepared.
Huh?
I'm not a believer in ghost stories, but I must confess, this seems strange business.
Oh, it came that night thundering down the valley, and then the brakes jammed on, jarring and tearing.
Now, if the train comes, then I'll believe the yarns. But trains can't run around without human beings to control them.
The tearing of the brakes and the grinding and the rasping and the shriek of the whistle, and then a dead man lying on the platform, and then the roar, louder, 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 and the crash into the river below. Don't you hear it? Oh, why don't you go? Well, there's no time.
Well, we can't go now.
Then stop up your ears and don't listen to it. Don't look at it. And remember what has happened to me. Be warned. Oh, be warned.
Now, the train can't come. It's impossible.
The bell. The signal bell. You all heard it. Now perhaps you'll believe me.
Damn strange.
It might have been the wind that caused that.
No, the bell, the signal bell, it always rings.
What's the time?
1 minute to 12.
What was that?
Oh, I think I heard a train whistle.
It's coming.
Your imagination.
No, I certainly heard a whistle.
Well, I'm going to see that.
No, stop.
By God, she's right.
What? The train. Don't you hear it?
I knew it. It's coming. It's coming.
Steady, old
it's
girl.
It's coming.
Oh,
it came that night thundering down the valley, on and on and on.
No, I'm going to see this. It's stuck. This one's locked too. We're shut in. We are! We're shut in, I tell you! We're shut in!
Listen to it! Lord,
I don't mind owning it.
You're sure she's not dead?
Oh, no, she's not dead. Her heartbeat is faint and yet pretty steady.
Say, haven't you got one of those, whatchamacallums, the listening in jiggers?
Stethoscope, you mean?
Yes, that's quite right.
No, I've none of my instruments with me. That's the devil of it all.
Well, then you don't know what's the matter with her, doctor?
I don't. She's had these strange turns before, but they've never ended like this. It seems like a stroke of some sort, and yet so many of the symptoms are missing.
What symptoms?
You wouldn't understand if I told you.
Tell me and see.
You're a very extraordinary young man. What do you want to know for? What difference does it make?
Oh, I don't know. Idle curiosity. I suppose if we're all going to have strokes, it would be rather useful to know when one was coming on, wouldn't it?
Okay.
Anything's gonna happen to us.
Oh, I expect so.
You are a prize idiot.
I don't know what it is, but you've all got it in for me.
Why can't you shut up? Every time you open your mouth, you say something inane.
I can't understand it. The train did come, right enough. We can't get away from it.
And then there's Miss Price. What sets her up like this?
I don't know what's the matter with her.
Don't you remember? She said she saw it, and she was going to tell us. I remember her words. I saw the driver, and he was...
Of course! That bears out the story of the ghost train. Anyone who sees it dies.
But my dear old thing, she's not dead.
Not yet.
You
can't tell. She's very ill.
Oh, it's all so terrible. Dick! Dick! Can't you take me away?
Oh, my dear girl, the doors are locked and the windows are barred. We can't get out.
You won't leave me, Dick, will you? I should die if you went away.
Oh. Don't worry about that. I won't leave you, Elsie.
Oh, I've been such a fool, Dick. Such a fool.
Oh, yeah. Never mind that now, old
girl. Oh, but I do mind, Dick. I mind terribly.
Oops. I say, it's a queer thing about that lady. If she hadn't taken ill, she might have told us something about the train.
No, she was telling us. It seems as though that train doesn't like being looked at.
But how can that make Miss Price ill?
I'm darned if I know.
It's no good worrying over the business, ladies and gentlemen. We're up against something too big for us.
Then you really think...
I can see no other explanation. When I came here tonight, I thought the legend of this place was just a silly local yarn. One must take the facts into consideration, though, and they can't be explained away. If it was Saul Hodgkins you found outside the door, how did his body get out of the ticket office? There's no window but a skylight.
If only she had told us something more before she fell.
My leg! Look!
Huh?
Huh?
What?
Oh. She's moving!
Oh!
By Jove, you're right. Better?
Hello.
Business.
I ought not to have given way and frightened you all. It's all right. The train won't come.
But the train did come!
I've been here all this time, haven't I?
Hang it all, you're the only one of us who saw it.
Please don't try and frighten me.
He's quite right! Don't you remember? We heard the train in the distance, and then you jumped on the chair to try and get out of the window.
Yes, I do remember. I did jump on the chair.
And then the train came.
No, it didn't.
Yes, it came tearing through the station just as you said it would. You broke the window, and after it had gone, you turned around and shouted out that you had seen it.
I saw it.
What, the train?
Yes, you said you had seen the driver, and you were just about to tell us who the driver was when you fell.
No, I don't remember.
This is the important point, Julia. Who was the driver?
Driver?
Yes!
I haven't the faintest idea.
But you saw him!
I didn't see anything. I jumped on the chair and then I must have fainted. I've never fainted before in all my life.
You fainted, all right. There's no doubt about that. But it was after the train came and not before. The question is this. What made you faint?
I don't know.
What was it you saw?
Even though I didn't see anything.
Well, look here, I'll shut up. Will you shut up? Okay, now, Miss Price, you gotta pull yourself together and tell us what.
Stop! Stop! This joke has gone on far enough.
Joke?
Can't you see I'm not well? I think it's cruel making a fool of me like this. You know I'm nervous and high strung, and yet you do this to me.
No one is trying to fool you. There is no joke.
Honestly?
I swear it.
So do I.
All I know is that I feel terribly ill.
Oh, well, now, let's try to piece things together a little.
But it's all terribly clear. It wasn't my imagination.
Yes, but we heard the signal bell. I remember now. We heard the train in the distance, and I jumped on the chair, and then I fainted.
Now listen, Julia. This is what really happened. The train came through the station, and you broke the window. Look, you can see for yourself. After the train had gone, you said you saw the driver, and just as you were going to tell us about it, you fell from the chair. You gave us a fearful shock. We thought at first you were dead.
I don't remember anything about that. Then the train did come.
Yes!
Yes, but none of you saw it.
You were the only one. We were locked in here. We couldn't get out.
We can't get out now.
Jolly thrilling, isn't it?
Oh, it's awful. I don't know what we're going to do.
We must all get away from here if we can.
I wish to goodness we had.
There's someone outside.
By Jove, there is. Oh, I'm going to see that.
No, stop.
What's up?
Have you forgotten the rest of the story?
I don't like it, you.
Who do you think it is out there?
Someone to open the beastly door, I hope.
Suppose it's Ben Isaacs.
Yes, say, suppose it's Ben. Who's Ben?
Don't you know the rest of the story? How Ben Isaacs, the driver, went mad?
Yes, they told us that.
That can't be. Who knows?
Oh, don't be a fool, man.
Oh, listen.
Who's there? Yes. Come in.
Well, we gotta get to the bottom of this.
Hello, Susan.
Stop it!
Oh, all right. I can't do anything around this thing.
It's gone, whatever it is.
Oh, thank God for that.
Oh, this beats everything.
You're right there. I wish we knew what the gate was.
Charlie, if it'd been a man, he would have answered. How many times did he knock?
Six.
Well,
what? I just remembered something. No. I shan't tell you. I might be wrong.
Oh, come on, Mrs. Murdoch. We're all in this, you know.
No, it's too horrible.
Oh, come along, darling. Out with it.
Well, it's just this. There were six knocks at the door. And the station master said there were six people killed.
Julia!
I don't think that has anything to do with it. We've no proof of it.
We have no proof of anything for that matter.
That's true enough.
It is Ben Isaacs.
What can we do?
I can't take it. I tell you, I can't take it.
Steady, Elsie. Steady.
Here we go.
It's still locked! I'm gonna break this one down!
There it is again.
We can't go out there with Bert.
We shall have to face it. It's madness to stay here.
Why? Something's the matter with the lights.
No. Good God, they're going out.
Charlie, where are you? This is the devil's work. Let's go. Let's go.
Dick?
I'm here.
Oh, well, something touched me. Something cold.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, my God.
Oh, it's me. Hello.
Look at that.
Oh. The door's open.
How cold it is.
Come on. Let's clear out.
Just a moment.
We don't have a moment. We must go quickly.
Just a second. We have to make some arrangements about Miss Bourne.
Oh, I should be afraid to go.
We shall be ready to bolt for
it. I think so too. Now, please.
What? Are you starting again?
I want you all to listen to me and take my advice.
Oh, you're a hell of a fellow to give advice on anything, aren't you?
In this case, old thing, I am.
Well, what is it?
I beg that none of us go. Let's all stay here. Hey.
What? Stay here? Good Lord, don't listen to the fool. Stay here indeed.
Yes, why not?
Because we're in great danger.
Yes.
We're up against some devilish thing. Yes. And if we stay, God knows what may happen to us. It was different when the doors were fastened. We didn't have a choice in the matter then. But now it is up to us to take the opportunity and quit.
Huh. Yes, but listen, old thing. In spite of it all, none of us has been hurt yet.
Huh? How about this lady?
She's fine now.
You're right.
Don't talk like a fool. We're not staying here a moment longer.
Right you are, old thing.
Then come on.
Right? Hit away, Prince Charming. Leave the Sleeping Beauty alone.
What's the game?
I'll stay here and look after Miss Bourne. You'll only do the old girl in digging her out at this hour, especially after the bun she was on.
I don't quite follow you.
That's all perfectly simple. I'll stay here and look after Miss Bourne. She'll be all right. She won't wake up until morning. That brandy of mine was pre-warm.
Oh.
Aren't you afraid?
My dear lady, I'm very nearly scared to a pulp.
Well, then why?
Because there's a world of difference between being afraid and running away. Good Lord, what do you think my people would say if they knew I'd been running about the countryside all night, grinning like a dog and getting my trousers muddy out of pure funk?
This isn't cowardice, it's common sense. Think of the ladies.
Oh, yes, I know you're thinking of that.
Now, look here!
You've been saying, now, look here, ever since we arrived in this place. I don't want to influence you either way. You can all do as you like, and I'll do as I like. All okay? What?
But we may not have a chance to go later.
Well, then run along, my little man.
We've simply got to go now.
I'm not stopping you, am I?
You're running us all into grave danger. You're trying to drive us mad. You have no right to jeopardize our safety. It's heartless of you.
Too true, old thing. Too true.
Then come along, quickly.
Now, look here.
See? I can sit up here, too.
Now, let's get this all perfectly clear. You can all go and take the ladies with you. I will stay here and look after Miss Bourne.
Oh, enough of this. You're coming.
On the contrary, my dear sir, I am not.
But what? Why not?
Because I happen to be a silly, obstinate ass. And when a silly, obstinate ass like me makes up his silly, obstinate mind, he usually gets his own silly, obstinate way. Now, do you follow me?
Once and for all, you're not staying here alone.
You surprise me. And what are you going to do about it?
I'll take you by force if necessary.
I suppose this fellow has a right to please himself, however great a fool he is.
Ah, thank you, kind sir.
I'm inclined to stay with him.
Good for you, old bean. Will you stay with me?
You can't.
Say it out like this.
I have my wife to consider.
Oh, quite.
Now listen here, you young fool.
I listen, you old villain.
What do you mean?
Nothing. I'm merely exchanging pleasantries with you. I don't see why he should have a monopoly of all the insults.
Why have you made up your mind to stay here?
Pure cussedness, for one thing.
And what else?
Idle curiosity.
About what?
I want to see what happens next. I'm jolly well going to sit here and see that train come back.
Wait any longer, it might be too late. Come on.
Now for it. Look. What? Ghost or no ghost, I've winged him, and that's that.
Wow. What have you done?
You'll soon see. Ah, listen, it's the train again.
Oh, it's coming back! It's coming back!
Yes, it's coming back, all right, but don't worry, I've got it all in hand. I've laid one ghost already, and now I'm going to switch that ghost train onto the siding.
Stop! Stop!
Oh, up with your hands! Where are you, Murdoch?
Oh, here I am!
Remember what I told you? Where's that revolver I gave you?
Here it is!
Ah! Now, watch this devil till I come back. Oh!
the tides.
Then there's no ghost train? Charlie!
No. My dear lady, that train is as real as the Montreal Flyer.
I tell you.
Shut up! But what's their object?
We shall soon know that.
Why, it's Saul Hodgkin!
Yes.
He was the engineer of that damn train. He got you all good with that sham dead trick of his. Got him all, Jackson?
I think so.
Who's this fellow?
Let's see.
Oh, Mr. Price!
Yes, he was your Ben Isaacs. I thought it was you I winged.
Put a bullet right through my arm, damn you.
Oh, too bad it wasn't through your head, damn you. Now then, what's the game?
Keep your mouth shut, Price.
I'm no squealer.
Had the doctor better see to his arm?
Doctor, what doctor?
Dr. Sterling!
Why, he's no more a doctor than you are. Didn't you see him try to take Miss Price's pulse with his thumb?
You're a fool, Jack.
Who the hell is this fellow?
Say, haven't you tumbled yet? You ought to know him. Detective Inspector Morrison of Scotland Yard.
Hey, detective! Yes, you all had rather a down on me, didn't you? I'll be damned. Got the trains all right, Jackson?
Sure, we got it.
What was it they were carrying?
Just what we figured. Booze and dope.
Yeah, dope.
Oh.
Dope. Allow me to introduce some rather interesting people. Mr. Lefty Jackson of the United States Revenue Office, Washington. Mr. Herbert Pineway of London. And Mr. John Silverton, late of Toronto, head of the Silver May Mining Company, which is in the works a few miles up the line. A nice little collaboration.
Smugglers?
Right, first guess. We've been tracking this gang for 2 years. That train we've just blown up was loaded with liquor, opium, cocaine, heroin, morphine, and every kind of narcotic. Thanks for your help, Murdoch.
Anytime.
Don't point the gun at me.
You can't pin anything on me.
Can't I, though? I wasn't sure until tonight, but I made up my mind to get you, especially after you killed Heath.
Who's Heath?
That tramp they found dead. One of our best men.
Yep, the best.
Say, you can tell us about that.
I didn't do it, mister. I didn't do it. It's their fault, every bit of it.
Shut up!
Oh, it's all right for you. You ain't got no wife and kids dependent on you. $50 a trip. They paid me to run that train from the old wharf to the work, but I didn't know I was hauling booze and dope. I swear to God I didn't.
That's a lie!
It's the God's truth, and you know it, and now I got to suffer for it. Damn you.
It's all right. He'll suffer with you. Our friend Pineway here is wanted by Scotland Yard for murder. That's why our department took a hand in the game. Take him away.
Come on, you outside.
What?
You too lively now.
Yep, lively.
Okay.
Well, I don't see it all, even now.
It's perfectly clear, Mrs. Winthrop. Pineway, who is wanted for murder, is the head of a gang who's been smuggling narcotics into the States for years. Mm-hmm. He joined forces with Silverton to create a distributing center in this out-of-the-way place for the stuff they smuggled into the country. What put us onto the thing was that Pineway, under another name, was wanted in Europe. The Washington people got a tip, and they sent Heath to investigate, and he was killed, murdered, in this very room.
The whole story of the accident was a fake.
No, an accident did happen. And there's a strong local superstition about the ghost train. Most likely that gave them their idea. Anyways, it made their jobs easier because the natives around here have been trained for years to run for their lives when they hear a train in the night. The great thing was, they didn't want us in this room tonight or the bottom knocked out of the ghost story on which they relied. So, when the station master found that he couldn't get rid of us, he went over to Price's house to tell them we were here. Price's house is only a half a mile away, not far. There was no time to lose. So they jumped up just as they were in their dinner clothes and came down here to try and fool us with their bag of tricks. That oil lamp is no oil lamp at all. It's wired to the electric current outside. It was all arranged. The fate and all.
No.
But why didn't Saul send us off to Price's?
Good Lord, they didn't want us there any more than here. Tonight was their busy night.
I am sure you are wrong about one thing. This poor girl is as innocent as I am. I understand. I know you're not to blame.
I'm not so sure about that.
I'm not so sure either.
I think I'll be going now.
Oh, but where will you go?
I don't know. This has all been so much for
just me. Just a moment.
What do you want with me?
Just who are you?
Oh, I
don't you?
Poor girl.
May I see you home?
Why, Charlie?
Well, you know.
Got the papers, Jackson?
Not a sign of them, not any of them.
Hey, get on with it. Have you got them?
What papers?
We think there's someone higher up in all of this, and we've reason to believe that a written message from him is on one of you.
And if we find him, there's going to be a lot of doing at headquarters, we can promise you.
I don't know what you're talking about.
We better take her with the others if she won't talk, Jackson.
Oh, we'll make her talk. Ooh.
For God's sake, not that. I can't explain.
What?
I do know.
Well, you know where they are. Well, then.
And there's more I can tell you, too. A lot more.
Bet there is.
But not here, not before all these people. I can't.
Are the cars here yet, Jackson?
They're on their way.
Look here, should we just go and leave you?
No! Okay. Go in there, and I warn you, this is a very serious matter for you. Boy. Leave this to me, will you, Jackson?
Well, I'm certain that girl knows nothing about all of this.
Oh, the motor cars are here, ladies.
Oh! 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 Oh!
Dear. Do you think they kept their room at the hotel?
I don't know why not!
By the way, Murdoch, how about a position with my Boston branch instead of South America? You're just the fellow I've been looking for. What do you think, Elsie?
Oh, splendid.
You mean it? I do.
Pex, do you realize what this means?
Yes, dear.
Look here. Here's my card. Look us up when you get back. Say about 10 days' time, and think of us when you're on your honeymoon. We're just starting on our second. Isn't that so, Elsie?
Oh, yes, darling.
Okay. So long. Farewell. Auf Wiedersehen.
Sayonara.
Close enough.
Oh, oh! Darling, now you don't have to go away.
How wonderful. I know.
Huh?
Huh?
Stick him up.
Ah! What does this mean?
It means, little man, that I hold all the cards. Well, well, to think that little fool should try to pull the wool over my eyes.
Who are you?
Oh, don't you worry about me. I'm fingerprinted at Scotland Yard all right now. Get out of my way. Get out of my way.
I'll be damned if I do.
You jolly well be if you don't. This is where I kiss you goodbye, and you're going to stand away from that door.
No.
Yes. Not enough fooling. When I shoot, I don't miss, and that little sweetie of yours there will be a widow. Come on now. Make up your mind. One.
For my sake, Charlie!
All right! Oh,
she's got more brains than you have. I'm the devil's grandmother! Oh,
I'm putting the bracelets on the devil's grandmother, LP.
Say, are you one or two?
I'm one too many for you. What?
How did you get out of there?
You forget our mutual friend saw her secret way out of the room. I found it.
You and I ought to do business together sometime.
What are you chewing?
Not gum. No, that's that little bit of paper you're after. Now go after it. You'll have a long ways to die for it. All gone.
Well, you'll get yours all right.
Oh, don't you worry about me. I'm not yellow, and I'll take what's coming to me with a laugh. Well, are we ready?
Yes.
All righty then. Nighty night, everybody!
Just a nice little snowbird, eh?
And you wanted to see her home.
Well, we've only one small trouble left here.
Oh, she's booming, Miss Bourne.
Oh, such a headache.
Oh, cheer up, Miss Bourne. The cars are here, eh? Soon we'll be safe in Rockland.
Oh, I'm so glad. Nothing exciting happened.
Oh, hell.
Ooh. Fun to do this play for a full crowd. Thank you so much. I hope you had a great time. This is our closing.
tonight, so we wanted to take a very quick second to thank our director, Sarah. They put a lot of time and effort into this behind the scenes, and they've been doing a really great job. So thank you so much for coming out tonight. Have a great Saturday night.
Yeah.
Thank you.